I got a vessel you go, comes right on to you as a rubber. Next one, same move, raise your hand, step through. This time you have half space. Before he strike, you go, you right if you right, you go strike. But we go throwing. Technique you go off, go forward, another hand. One more time. Last one, right here. This time you go. Low. And down. So basically the same thing. That's the elbow. Step in. We call corner drop. Similar. But same. Really, same way you control. Step out, one, two. Step in. Change your partner. Pinning. We call it little mechanism. We call energy. You have a muscle, you have everything. So if you compare it to muscle, right? He's a big guy, maybe I can't bend any. But it could be we can bend the wrist. Right. Can bend the wrist as well as is can bend the wrist doesn't mean nothing, it's a center. It's a really down the center, then press up on the wrist. Within the zone. Combine. If you just bend your wrist, doesn't mean nothing. Doesn't mean. Really the balance and bend the wrist the other way, then total take out the bar. Now when you do this one, the now concentrated bending for his wrist. Step out, try to bend his elbow. So that is the condition. Then we drop elbow down. We believe that to lead the balance. It's a timely if you do so, we can throw more dynamic. This is a ball. So that first one we put the guys, okay, actual direction translation is te is hand in Japanese. Kote means small hand. Where with the big, small, if you chop off the hand, the small hand right there, which means wrist, technique actually, hand, neck, this is the kotegashi. Now, elbow, this is the one, so you are step aside, holding elbow right there. Now push down to the elbow. So this is the way. So now we've created a more movement, momentum. Right? And you're driving a pattern here, or we go this way. Continue to turn, you step aside. Now you have step and dynamic. Then you push the slide in. I look at it in terms of where this is right here. Okay,
heel.
What?
Plant your heel.
Plant my heel. Alright? So you touch with your toe, plant the heel, then inhale. I am more concerned at this point with your body motions. I haven't said anything about how to do the Aikido, what to do with your hands, or how to deal with his arm. I'm more concerned about what's happening here. Then we'll get to the other one. Anyway. This is not created by taking it and pushing on his wrist. It's created through the whole motion. We have two energies coming together. The weak point in all of this is the wrist. So you want both energies, his energy coming in, your energy going back, right in going in his poor little wrist. Here, that's where the bend happens. Now, there's a little more detail about Aikido. I look at it this way because it's what I call mechanical. Meaning you're making the hands and the wrists and the bones and the arm move. If you look at trying to make a technique totally pain-based, you got somebody who's drunk, on drugs, feels no pain, it's not gonna work. But if you look at it from a mechanical point of view, making the bones work, then it will work, regardless of their condition. So again, as you come in, look for this bend. Point the fingers to the mat, and bend. Go to the other Aikido. Now, we're still going to do the advantage of this motion here. But this time, we're going to sit. Step back, raise your hand. Back, roll. The idea over here, again, is don't use your arms. Use your body as this. This one. Here, as this happens here, it releases your hand. His motion, because he goes beyond where he's stable, it's easy to move.